In this video, we are going to take a look at how we can create custom cursors for our WordPress website using the plus add-ons for Gutenberg. And with that, you will be able to create some eye-catching cursors like this one, where you can add your custom image, or maybe you can add some creative text that will follow your web cursor, or maybe you can add some progress bar right inside your web cursor. So all that will be done using the mouse cursor block of plus add-ons for Gutenberg. So if that sounds interesting and you also want to design some eye-catching cursors, then hop in and I'll show you everything step by step. My name is Ankit Sharma from the team POSIMYTH, and if you want to deep dive in the world of Gutenberg with plus add-ons, then make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so that you can get notified about our two videos that we publish every week. That said, let's dive in our WordPress backend and create some eye-catching cursors. Alright, so here we are in our WordPress backend. And if we go in the plugins section, here we have the plus add-ons for Gutenberg free as well as the pro version. And once we have installed these two plugins, we can go to plus settings and then go to plus blocks. And here we need to search for cursor. And this is the mouse cursor Gutenberg block, and as you can see, it's part of the pro plan of plus add-ons for Gutenberg. So make sure you have the pro plan of this plugin installed and activated. And after that, we just need to turn on this block and then click on save. Now let's go ahead and create a page and see how this block works. So here we have a page where we have just added a sample content. So let's say we want to add our custom cursor here. We can search for cursor, and this is the TP mouse cursor block. Let's add it. And this is just a preview area where you can see how your cursor will look. And if you look on the right hand side, the first option is backend design box. And this is the backend design box here. And if you turn this off, you won't be able to see the preview. So this area we can use to see the preview of what we are designing as our custom cursor. After that, we have the first option, that is cursor area, which means where we want to show our custom cursor. The first option is body. So this will make the cursor visible on all over our web page. After that, we have the row option. Now if we select that, this custom cursor will only work in this particular row that we have designed here. And if we select this column, so it means that our custom cursor will only work in this left hand side column, because this is the place where we have added it. And if we choose the block, the last option, this is going to work only in this block area. So let's first select body and see how it works. Now after this, we have an option for type. So here we define what kind of custom cursor we want. So the first option is cursor icon. We can choose follow image, we can choose follow text, and we can also choose follow circle. So we are going to take a look at each one of them one by one. So first start with custom cursor, and after that we have an option for predefined, or if we choose custom, we can upload an image here. So first, let's keep it on predefined, and after that we have an option to select what type of predefined cursor we want. So here we can see crosshair. We can select any option from these predefined cursors. So let's say we click on this help, and now to see how it's going to look, we can bring our cursor here on this preview area. So if you notice, as soon as I move my mouse inside this preview area, we can see a custom cursor. Instead of help, if I select this grabbing, if I move my cursor inside this preview area, this will be the new custom cursor. And if I move the mouse out, it will bring back to my default cursor. So let's just update this here and see how it works in the front end. So this is the front end of our website. And if you notice that we already have a custom cursor, which is working on our header, which is working on our main body, as well as on our website footer. So this is how we can choose any predefined cursor from here. Now instead of predefined, let's turn that to custom. Now after selecting custom, We can now upload an image here, but make sure your cursor image should be below 50 by 50 pixel. So let's upload one. So here we already have an image, and as you can see, it's 48 by 48 pixels. So let's select that. And if we move the cursor here in the preview area, you can see that this is going to be our new custom cursor. And after this, we have an option for mouse cursor click. So if you turn that on, here you get an option to add another image, which can be used as our cursor whenever we point any clickable element. So let's say we add another image like this one. And now let's update this page and refresh the front end. So now you see that we have this fire icon as our custom cursor. But if we move on to any element which is clickable like this button, you see that the cursor icon changes to that click hand. So this is how you can use a custom image as your cursor and use a different image on the clickable elements. And once again, our custom cursor is working on every part of the website. But what about the other pages? If we go ahead and click on the home page, we see that we lost our custom cursor. Now, in order to fix this, you need to create your custom header and footer, which you can easily do by using the free Nexter builder. And while you are designing your custom header or footer, you can add the cursor block there and choose the cursor area as body. And with that, your custom cursor will be visible on every page and all over the web page. So this is how you can make sure that your custom cursor will be visible on all the pages. So now, once the custom icon is done, let's move on to the next option, follow image. Now, once we select this, we get an option to upload the image here. So let's say we upload this image, which is 512 by 512 pixels. Let's select that. And after uploading this image, let's see in the preview area. You can see that it's a huge image that is following our cursor. So with that, we can reduce the width of this image from here. And now you see that it's looking much better. So you can play around with the size here and see which one works best. Below this, we can set the left offset. So you can decide how far or close you want to keep this image, which will follow your cursor. So this is how we can do that. And below that, we can decide the cursor top offset. So let's reduce this to maybe minus 10. So this is how it's look. So if you decrease it a bit more, it will go on the top of your cursor. So let's keep it on minus maybe 10 or 15. So this one looks much better. And after this, once again, we can upload a mouse cursor on click. So here we are going to use the same icon that we have uploaded last time. So let's update this and see how it looks in the front end. So let's refresh this page. And now you see our normal cursor with a follow image. So wherever I move the cursor, this custom image will follow. And if we move the mouse on any clickable element, this will change to this custom image here. So this is not going to replace my cursor, but it will add an image which will follow my default cursor. And just like our follow image, we can choose follow text. And once we select that, we get an option for the text that we want to show as our cursor. So with this default value, if I show you the preview, you can see that follow text is accompanying with our default cursor. So maybe we can add a smiley here and let's type in follow the smile. Why not? So this is how it's going to look. So maybe we can do a little bit of designing here. So let's keep the left offset as 125 or maybe just 100. And the top offset, make it 5. So this one looks much better. And after that, we have mouse cursor click option as well. So here we will define the text which will be visible whenever our cursor is on any clickable element. So here maybe we can add a different text. And now if we move on to the style tab, here we can define the typography of our custom text that we have added. So you can play around with the font family, size and everything in typography. And you can also decide the text color. So we will keep it on black. And you can decide the max width, padding, and we can add background. So let's do that. So let's add a white background and we will give it a border, which will be 1 pixel. And let's say we add this maybe orange color border. So this is going to look something like this. If you see that in the preview area. And in the padding, maybe we can add some 6 pixel or 5 pixel padding like this. So you can always see the preview here. And after this, we will add a border radius. So let's add 8 pixel. And maybe we can add some box shadow. So this is how it's going to look. So let's update this and see how it looks in the front end. So let's refresh our page. So now you see we have this follow the smile custom text, which is following our normal cursor. And if we go on any clickable element like this button, this changes the text as well as our smile emoji. So this is how you can add custom text. So you can easily use these custom follow text cursor, maybe to give a tooltip or maybe to highlight anything on your website. So this will be very helpful at that point. Alright, so now after follow text, we are going to move on to the next cursor type, that is follow circle. If we select that, here we have the first option that is predefined and second one as custom. Predefined, as we know, the cursor type will be from the predefined shapes. And for the custom, here we can upload our custom image. So if we come back in predefined, and here in the circle style, we have border cursor, progress cursor, and blend cursor. So we are going to cover all the three one by one. So first, if we select border cursor, here if we move on to the preview area, here we can see a circle following our normal cursor. And here we can set the max width and height of this circle. So if we choose max width and height as 200, this is how it's going to look. And if we choose 20 by 20 for both height and width, so this is how we can increase the size of this following circle. If we scroll down, once again, we have the left and the top offset, which is looking perfectly fine right now. And here we have the Z index. So right now you will see that it's set on 99. If we set this to 0, now this Z index will define how this follow circle will look once it is over any web element. So let's say first increase the size of this circle so that we can see it clearly. And if we go in style and we choose the follow circle, first let's add a background color, maybe this orange. So this is how it's going to look. And for the hover, we will select red, something like this. So this color will be visible once we move the cursor on any clickable element. And after this, we have transform CSS option. Now, what is this transform CSS? You can go ahead and search this in Google. And these are some CSS properties that you can use for doing the animation on your web page. So let's say we choose scale and we will make it 2. So this will increase the size of our follow circle once it will be on any clickable element. And here we can set the transition duration. So we will keep it below 1 so that we can instantly see the transition in the size of this circle. With all these settings, let's update this and see how it looks in the front end. So let's refresh this page. So here is our circle, which is following our normal cursor. And if we move on to any clickable element, like in our navigation on the top, you see that the size is getting scaled up and we also got the red color. Once again, if we move on to this button, again, we can see it's scaling and changing the color. Now, let's say we set this Z index to 0. Now update this again and see how it looks in the front end. So this is our normal cursor with a circle following it. And if we mouse over on any element, you see that because the Z index is set to 0, it's behind all the web elements. And if we go on any link, you can see that it's working perfectly fine. It's scaling up and changing the color, but it is behind all the web element. Same as with this button. It's increasing the size and changing the color as we have defined, but because of the Z index set to 0, it is showing behind these elements. So this is how you can play around with this Z index. Now, instead of predefined, we can choose custom And once again, we can upload any image here. Let's select this and let's update this and see how it looks in the front end. So now you see our cursor got updated and we also have a following circle. And again, because of the Z index, it's showing behind all the elements. So this is how you can use a cursor icon and get a circle following that custom icon. Now, if we come back to this predefined and here in the circle style, instead of this border cursor, we will now choose blend cursor. We will come back to the progress circle in a minute. Now, once we select that, it's very close to what we have done in the border cursor. So everything remains the same. We will keep the width and height same. We will keep the offset same. And now let's make the Z index as maximum so that our circle will always be on very top. If we take a look a preview here, this is how it looks. So right now we have selected the blend cursor, which means whenever we move cursor on any web element, our circle which is following our cursor will be visible in the blend mode. And how we can set this blend mode? We need to go to the style tab here. And here we can select what kind of blend mode we want. So right now it is set to difference. We can set it to multiply, maybe screen. So this is how it's going to look. So let's say we make it blue color or maybe red color. This will be much visible. So here you can see that the blend mode set to screen and we can see a little bit of red color here once we do the mouse over. And for the hover, we will keep it on red with scale 2. So let's update this here and see how it looks in the front end. So let's refresh this page. So here is our cursor, but we do not see our circle following it because right now it is in the blend mode. Once we do the mouse over on any element, this is how it's going to look. And if we mouse over on any clickable element, this is going to scale up and change the color to red. And it will be always in the blend mode that we have selected in the backend. So now instead of blend cursor, we will choose progress cursor. And now we got some new option here. First circle size, second circle size. And here we have the offset. So if we move the mouse in the preview area, this is how it's going to look. So we can see we have two circles here. And that's why we see these options. First circle size and the second circle size. So if we increase the size a bit more, so you can see the first circle is moving away from the second one. And if we decrease the size of the second one, it's very clear now. So once we set the size and offset, let's move on to the style tab. And here for the follow circle, we have the circle color. Let's select our orange color again. So this is how it's going to look. And here we can set the stroke size of this circle. So here we can increase or decrease the size. So we will keep it on 10. That will look good. And here we have the fill color option. So if we want, we can do a fill color as well. So let's say if we choose this one. So this is how it's going to fill inside our circle. And the next option is circle progress color. So here, let's say we choose this dark purple, something like that. So this is how it's going to look. And if we reduce the size of this circle, this is how it's going to look. So if we reduce a little bit more, so you can see clearly the inner circle is in dark purple and a little bit thinner than the outer one. Once again, we have the CSS transform, so we will not use it here. We will use this in the hover. So again, we can define all these styling in for the hover as well. So here we have the CSS transform scale 2 and our animation set as 0.6, same as earlier. So now let's update this and see how it looks in the front end. So let's refresh the page. So now we have our normal cursor and we have a circle here. But we do not see our inner circle. And that will be visible once we scroll down the page. As soon as we start scrolling down, you can see the inner circle building up as a progress bar. And if we come back in the layout again, here we will change the Z index and we will make it maximum so that our circle will always be on top. Let's update this and let's refresh the front end. So here is our normal cursor followed by our circle. but we don't see the inner circle right now, and that will be visible as soon as we start scrolling our page down. So here, as soon as we start scrolling down, it's building up as a progress bar, and as soon as we move up, we can see that the inner circle is going back to zero. And once again, if we mouse over on any element, this will start scaling up. So this is how we can create a progress bar right in our cursor. So this is how easy it is to create some custom eye-catching cursors for our website using the plus add-ons for Gutenberg. Now with this, I hope you will be able to create some amazing looking eye-catching cursors for your website. But just in case you think that there is something missing and you wish if this could be added in this plus add-on, then you can always visit our roadmap page here. You can go ahead and create an account, and here you will find a feature request form. And once you fill up this simple form, your request for the feature that you want to add in the plus add-ons will directly go to our developers, and we will try our best to make your request live as soon as possible. So if you like this video, then make sure you hit the like button, and if you want to learn more about such amazing features of plus add-ons, then make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so that you can get notified whenever we upload our next video. So that's it for this one, and I'll see you in the next video.